But which are your problems? My problem is my problem. Is that right? So all problems are not problems. So we've removed half the problem now. Is that right? All problems are not not problems. My problem is problem. So we have come to that level right now. So my problems, how many are they compared to world problems? Very few. So if I solve very few problems, then my problems are done. So let us analyze, let us go further. So the logic is, my problem is my problem and no other problem. So if you can prove that your problem is actually not your problem, then you have no problem. Is that right? Right? So let us analyze. We are going to divide the world into two. People have divided into many different pieces, that's okay. According to Vedanta, let us divide the world into two. Right? How do we divide the world into two? Very simple. We divide the world into I and the others. Can you see?
Yes.
Right. Aham and idam. This or that. Do we have a confusion in this kind of division?
No.
No confusion. We are all very clear. This is me, that is you. So where are my problems? My problems are here and others' problems are? That is not my problem, right? So we don't have to discuss. So how do we refer to ourselves? We refer to ourselves as I. We refer to others as?
You,
they, it, etc., etc., etc. So be very clear. That is that, this is me. Now let us analyze a little further. When you say I, what do you mean by I? Who is this I? Swamiji. Only yesterday I checked. 86.4. What? Wait. I? So who am I? This is me. This body, that's I. Fantastic, very good. So do you have a mind? Yes, of course, Swamiji. I have a mind. So that is I. And do we have an intellect? Of course, yes. I also have a intellect. But we don't go around saying, I have an intellect, I have a mind, I have a body. We don't go around saying that. We refer to it in different ways. How? I am beautiful. Swamiji Ganesha has a kumbhikai, I have vadikai. Others only have nambikai. Right? So we don't say I am the body, but we refer to the body as this. I am fat, I am thin. We also refer to the mind. How do we refer to the mind? Mind is the seat of feelings. So how do we refer to the feelings? I am sad, I am happy, and now Swamiji, I am confused. Right? I am clear, etc., etc. Right? So we say I am the mind, and so too we say I am the intellect. I am intelligent. I make right choices, I've got great memory, I can analyze very well. So this is what we say, I'm the body, I'm the mind, I'm the intellect, and of course, I'm the soul also. The life that exists in me, I'm the soul as well. So far we are very clear. But now we have to start analyzing. What do we analyze? We have to use a logic. What is the logic? The logic is this. I say, this is a pen. Right? And this pen is different from me. There's no confusion in that. This is a pen, and this pen is different from me. Now, on what basis are we saying this? I say this is me. On what basis is the differentiation?
I see it.
Exactly. I see the pen, therefore the pen is different from me. Have any of you seen your own eyes? You saw the reflection of your eyes, correct? Did you see your own eyes? No, you can't see yourself. The subject cannot see himself, the subject can only see the object. And this is called drik. This is called drishya. So drik, the seer, and this is called the drishya, the seer. Right? So this is the drishya, this is the drik. So drishya is different from the drik. So when we talk about the pen, when we talk about the mic, when we talk about others, it's quite clear. Do you see your hand? Do you see your leg? Of course. And you know what is so interesting? I say, this nail is me, the moment I cut it off, is the nail fallen down there? Is it me? It's not me. Then if that is not me, how can this be me? The hair here, I say, this is me, don't touch my hair. Once I cut it off, I don't want to touch it. Is that right? So if that hair is not me, how can this hair be me? Swamiji, hair and nail, I understand. Just imagine, only imagine, okay? If one finger is cut off and it falls down, I said imagine, right? Then is that finger you?
Yes.
Is that you?
No.
Lying down there, is that you?
No.
Then if that is not you, how can this be you? Swamiji, finger, I understand. What about kidney? They are replaced, still you remain. Heart?
Yeah, replaced.
Of course, even the heart is... So which part of you, of the body are you? None of the parts. So the body is drishya. You are the drink. Oh. So then what happened? This body has to go here. Because body is the drishya. You are the drink. And applying the same logic, do you all feel your mind? Yes. You are able to see your mind. You are able to say, I am happy. Now I am sad, now I am confused, yesterday I was happy, today morning I was sad, I am agitated right now, etc, etc, right? So you are able to see the state of your mind, you are able to see your emotions, emotions is the mind, emotions is the thought, and therefore, correct? So you are not your mind also. Right? Then what about intellect? Swamiji, I never thought I was intelligent. That is so easy. Are you the intellect? No, of course. Why? Because you're able to see your intellect. Swamiji, I was not intelligent earlier. Now I've become so intelligent. I have recognized something. Some new idea has come. I'm so creative. I'm so etc, etc. Are you able to see your intellect? Of course. So what has happened now? Intellect also has become drishya. You are the drip. Now let us apply the first logic. My problem is my problem. Other problems are not
my problem.
So why? Physical problem? It belongs to the body. It is not your problem. Financial problem? Belongs to what? Belongs to the
mind,
intellect. Is it your problem? It is the mind's problem, a relationship problem. Whose problem?
Mind.
It is not your problem. So finished, you have no problem. Correct? So why do you feel sad?
It sounds nice.
Swamiji, yes, very nice. What? கேட்கறதுக்கு நல்லா இருக்கு அனுபவிக்கிறது நாங்க தானே கரெக்ட்
எஸ்
சோ சம்திங் வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் நன் ஆஃப் தேம் ஆர் யுவர் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் யட் யூ ஃபீல் இட் இஸ் யுவர் ப்ராப்ளம் தட் இஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம் That is the problem. What? That you feel. So Gurudev said, for those who feel, this world is a tragedy. And for those who think, this world is a comedy. So what does Vedanta tell us? Vedanta says, think. Think. Avicharena krito bandha, vicharena nivartate. That which has been caused by misunderstanding can only be removed by right understanding. And it is here that knowledge comes into play. But Swamiji, if that is not me, why is it that I am feeling it is me? Oh, that also has an answer. You are feeling and I am supposed to give the answer. That's very interesting. You are feeling, I should ask you, why are you feeling? But see, so interesting, that though it is not me, and it is to something else, I still can feel it. And what is that? Something interesting, when your own son or daughter has headache, you feel the pain, is it not? Something more interesting, the why feel is happening, right? Or let us say you love the Indian cricket team. Indian cricket team wins. How do you feel?
Happy.
Don't you feel you won?
Yes.
Did you even go to the ground?
Yes.
Did you even play one ball? Did you do anything? And how come you feel you won? If Australia team wins, what do you feel? Let us say they don't play against India, don't worry. If Australia team wins, what do you feel? You don't feel anything. Why? Why is it that you felt with Indian team? Why is it you didn't feel with Australian team? Because with Indian team, I identified. With Australian team, I did not. So the interesting part is, though it is not me, if I identify with that, what happens to that can affect me. My company's profit elates me. Opposite company's profit. Right? Also saddens me because I'm affected by it. But some company's profit? No effect. So the point is, though it is not me, if I am identified with it, that can affect me and I can feel happy, I can feel sad. Though I am not the body, though I am not the mind, though I am not the intellect, just because of identification, whatever happens to the body affects me, whatever happens to the mind affects me, whatever happens to the intellect affects me. And what do I do? With this identification, I create what is called identity, which is not me. Is that right? So with the identification, with that which is not me, I create what? An identity for whom? For myself. That is not me actually. Something very interesting. When did you become husband or wife?
After
the day you got married. The minute before you got married, did you become husband or wife?
No.
You didn't. You were neither a husband nor a wife. What happened a minute later? I identified with the role of the husband or the wife. I became. So after that, every decision that I take is based on what? The identity. Is that right? So whatever happened to the identity affected me. Is that right? So identity, and what identity is it? Is it the right identity or is it the false identity? It is the... Because I am identifying myself with which I am not. And And what is it? It is called false identity. And not only that, I'm identifying with the body, mind, intellect. From there on, I'm identifying with so many things related to the body, related to the mind, related to the intellect. I'm the husband, I'm the son-in-law, I'm the wife, I'm the daughter-in-law, I'm rich, I'm poor. For whom is the identity? It's only to the body, it's only to the mind, it's only to the intellect.